This video is an archive of a live broadcast by BCH Technologies. In this show, we show you how to make a spongeless refillable cartridge for Canon printers. We made a mistake at the end of this video. Please see the second video about how to correct it. The link is posted below. Warning. Although we are drop-dead handsome, we are not professional actors. We don't use props and things may not be 100% working in the show.
I'm Jason.
Okay, you probably already know what we're trying to do, so I don't want to spend too much time tell you why we want to make a spongeless cartridge.
And how's it going, John?
Okay, to make this
John's work, doing good.
Okay, to make this work, we need two cartridges, of course. And you can use any kind of cartridges. Some people ask me if you want a brand new cartridge. No, you don't need it. And those are pretty beat up already. One of them already get a cap off. So, and this is color one, already be refilled, and we threw it aside, and it's really dry. And first thing you do is...
John, we're going to make a spongeless cartridge today.
Okay, let me soak it in with a cleaning solution for right now. So, okay, first thing you want to do is you want to wrap around it with a saran wrap. So you don't put the dust over your printhead, okay? And this part is the hardest part, to take the cap off. So I'm going to do it slowly, and can you zoom in to show people there's a seam here? Okay. See the seam? So what you're going to do is, you can zoom really a little bit. You want to cut on this seam, and you want to have a utility knife, which is strong, sturdy. Just hold the cartridge and go up and down. And when it start peeling, just peel it out. So now you can take the sponges out.
Okay. Right, Greg? He says, I'm glad this would be available for replay to be able to rewind.
Okay. And the one is off. You can see there are three chambers. You got a red, blue, and the yellow. Here's the sponge. And now you need a kit. You're gonna have two covers in this kit. And then you have a priming syringe. Let me put a priming syringe there and open up the color kit. Inside the color kit, you can see there are three color plugs. Those are for the refills. And then there are three ink regulators, not the ink, pressure regulators. Those three things regulate the pressure. So our goal is we're going to glue this cover on. And when we glue it on, we make every chamber be airtight. This is really important. If you do not make it airtight, this whole thing doesn't work, because if it's not airtight, the air can get in from the seam, then your pressure regulator is not going to work, and the ink is going to flow out. So make sure you have an airtight bond. One thing we do is we use the sandpaper to sand it a little bit. And now you can see it's flat. And you can check whether it's flat or not. You don't want to have anything that's not flat. Okay. Now we try to put it on a couple times just to make sure that we're okay. We'll be like this, and now we can put a glue on it. This is just regular super glue from dollar store. The best glue I had is actually a clear Gorilla glue, because that glue is settled in like about 4 to 6 hours. So if something is wrong, I can go back and change it. But this glue is settled within seconds, so it's kind of too quick for me. And let's do this. Oh, by the way, do not use the brown Gorilla glue. The brown one foams up and creates lots of fumes. And okay, this is a one-time deal. Okay, if you do not glue it airtight, you have to restart again and take the color the cover off, sand it down, and glue it again. Okay, now you can see it. So you can see the magenta here. Here is not airtight, but everything else it looks really good. So I'm just going to add a little bit. Let's go. I'm going to just add a little bit on the edge. Now it's good. Okay, I'll put it here. It looks pretty good. And now this guy, the black, same thing. I'll take the stump out. Sorry for the noise. Again, we try a couple times to make sure we know how to put it on. Oh, sorry, I read. Okay. Now we put the super glue over it. pesky. And put the plug back. And the red and the blue one. And after this, you don't need a priming clip. All you need to do is use this to blow one, use the priming syringe to blow 1 mL of air into each chamber. And you blow it into the air pressure regulator. If you feel resistance, you don't have to push it really hard. If you feel the resistance, just release. You can see the ink already flowing out. That's good sign. Okay, make sure the electronic ribbon is clean. We're gonna do the same thing for the black. What you want is, you want at home when you do this, make sure it dries for a couple hours before you do this. Right now, because we do a demo, we don't have the time to let this dry. So it might not be airtight.
I hope you enjoy this video. Don't forget to see the second video about a problem we found after the show and how we corrected it. Please visit us at www.bchtechnologies.com. Happy printing. Cheers.